All right, Mr. Gardner, take us out.
So, when I was growing up, my whole life was dedicated to sports, and my sport was football. I was really good at football, and I loved it. And as you know from my last speech, that didn't really totally work out. I blew out my ACL. I've actually blown out both my knees. But anyway, so it kind of just left me in a weird place, because in high school, like around the school, everyone kind of knew who I was, or I would go into town, my hometown, and people would know who I was. I was the kid who got all the touchdowns. That's literally what people knew me by. And then all of a sudden, after the ACL was gone, no one really cared anymore. And that was kind of weird to adjust to, because it was hard for me to accept that. You know, is that I felt like I was a racehorse who broke its leg. Because what do they do to racehorses who break their leg? They shoot them, because they have nothing left to give. And that's how I felt. It kind of made me feel like I didn't really have a meaning anymore. And it kind of threw me in this really dark, emotional, and isolated place, which can be really hard to deal with. And so what I started connecting with was artists. See, I didn't really talk to anybody. I closed myself off from all my friends. And I was always the kid walking around the hallways with headphones in. And because that was my way of connecting with something. And my favorite artist was Kid Cudi. He's a rapper, not really even totally classified as a rapper, but he was someone who came into the game, same right there, came into the game and did things a little bit differently. You know, because the whole genre is all about having money, having women, and all these other things. But he came in and he related to kids. And he could come in and talk about his feelings and his emotions and things that he was going through that kids could really connect with. And so one thing I want to talk about is music and brain development. So when children have at least 2 years of music training, their brain can develop, accelerate brain development. And so one thing I want to talk about is, so if an artist can have such a big influence on your life, should they be responsible for the content of their art? Because my favorite artist pulled me out of a dark place, and he was able to pull me out of somewhere where I didn't feel like I had anywhere else to go. And I was really depressed, and I was considering suicide for a little while, just because I didn't feel like I had any meaning. And for someone to use their art to change my life and really do something like that and use their power to talk to millions of people to make a change, it's really incredible. But the United Nations says that an artist has the right to freedom of artistic expression and creativity. They can express themselves however they please. They don't have to have a filter on anything. But here's where it gets kind of tricky. Is hip hop. So the thing is that hip hop is the most popular genre today, and that's just a fact. All the kids are listening to hip hop. Their parents might not like it because of things like derogatory language, over-sexualizing women, and glorifying drug use and violence. But the thing is, it's not going anywhere, because it's what all the kids are listening to. It's what everyone likes right now. So instead of trying to get rid of hip hop because parents don't want their, or parents were not wanting their kids to listen to it because of the content, maybe we start following artists that want to do things differently. And because there's artists out there, and this is Kid Cudi on the Arsenio show, and he comes out and he says, "I think the braggadocio money cash hoes thing needs to be deaded." And that's just such a big part of the genre, and the fact that he's willing to come out and take a stand, although he was brought up along people like Kanye West and things like that, who are known for being cocky or loving themselves and all these other things, but he comes out and he wants to make a change, and he wants to help kids who feel alone. One of the things he said was, "My main goal is to make kids not feel alone and stop them from committing suicide." So, That's him. And although an artist has the freedom to be whoever they want to be, he chooses to do things in a different way. Thank you.
All right.
I feel like I want to get the close up.